When we persist the objects in the database using Aurelius ORM, we need those tables to be created in the database to hold data. Who is going to create those tables? Well, Aurelius can do that for you, and that's why updating the database is my number 7 of my top 10 Aurelius features. You can create the tables and columns in the database, of course, but Aurelius already has a feature for that. I'll give you the how it works. This is an entity, take customer here, with ID and name properties and some attributes to customize the mapping, so the table name customers and the column name customer name. And here is a sample application that I'm using that entity. I have a button update database, and all that it takes to update the database is create a T database manager's instance and call update database. And Aurelius will extract the existing structure of the database, check what's missing, and perform the updates. Let's run replication. When I call update database, you see that it creates the create table customers with the ID and customer name columns there. The statements are being displayed using the dbManager.SQLStatements property, which is filled when I call update database. You have the list of all the needed statements to update it. And note that I have this execute statements checkbox, which means that if it's not checked, it will only call validate database. The difference between update database and validate database is simply that the first one actually executes the statements, and validate database just do all it needs to do, but does not execute them. So we can check the generated statements without having to execute the statements in the database. The database I'm using is the SQL server here. So we can see that it's empty. There are no tables there. If I mark the checkbox and call update database again, it will actually create a table for us, DBR customer. And we can see that the table is created here with columns ID and customer name. Now, another interesting thing that the database update feature has is this validation of the database, which is a list of actions, warnings, and error detailed differences between the existing database structure and the target database structure, the one that Aurelius needs for the existing entities. And those are displayed still in the T database manager object in the properties actions, warnings, and errors. We are displaying this simple application here. We are displaying the content of those actions, warnings, and errors. We can see that the only action that it displays is a table created action with information of table customers. It means that the validation indicates that one table needs to be created. Now, the best part, in my opinion, of the update database is, besides that validation, which shows detailed information, is that since it updates the database, it detects the difference between the existing structure and the target structure, is that it's easy for you to keep going with your application and maintaining it. So for example, if I have a version 2 of my application that I have created a new entity country and added 2 properties to my customer class, which will be birthday property and country property, which is a association with the T country class. Aurelius can create what is missing in the database, the missing columns and tables for us in the database. Let's see how it happens, how it works. Let's call update database. And what did it do? It's extracted the existing information from the database, so it knows that there is already a table customers there. So there is no create table customers statement here. Instead, there is an alter table customers to create the country ID field and another to create the birthday field or column, whatever you want to call it. And there is the create table country statements to create a country table. And finally, another statement that creates the foreign key between the customers table and country table. Note that we can even specify with the attributes the name of foreign key if you want to. Foreign key customer country. Let's execute. And then we also can change that name using those attributes. The validation here shows us that three actions are done. A country table is created, two columns are created, birthday and country ID, and a foreign key is going to be created from customers to country. It's a warning because existing data might be incompatible. If, for example, we already have data in the country ID, in the country ID field, it might not work. That's why it's a warning here, but that's Aurelius will execute it because the country ID column is being created right now. If we actually check the checkbox execute statements to actually execute these statements, we can see in our database that new data was created, the country table is created, and in the customers table, the two columns, country ID and birthday, are created, and also the foreign key FK customer country is created. That's the update database feature. The key point of it is the fact that it updates the database, it extracts the existing structure and only changes what is missing, and the fact that it gives us detailed information about the differences between the two schemas. That's why it's a favorite feature of mine, and I hope you have enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to receive news about upcoming videos, and thanks for watching.